So welcome to one of the best roguelike games of the year. Probably this one and The Last Spell are the top contenders. I don't want to get into too many details, but this is a great game with a lot of great art and also a lot of great mechanics. But this is one of those games that you just play and play and play and you don't really get bored with it. You just unlock new stuff and have more fun with it. I mean, this is exactly what the gaming world needs, a lot more indie games like this one. Also, I'll do the tutorial because it's kind of important in the beginning.
My head.
I played the demo, so I kind of know what to do. So you have to unveil the land around you. Come on. Oh, you need to use it over here. Okay. As you can see, it's also based. So it's based on your combat skills. It's based on what you choose to get. It's also based on the pathing choices, so I guess it's just a lot of choices all over the place. That's nothing. That's a combatant. This is how you get your first companion.
Let's do this.
He's also a hero, of course. Okay, let's kill more monsters. I mean, the basic story is that you're kind of in a book and you need to discover the pages or the chapters or whatever. I even forgot about that story, but let's hop into the combat because this is where the real game the really fun gameplay starts. As you can see, we have cards from both of our heroes. He'll do 15 damage. That means we need to gain 8 block. He also goes in front, and some skills he can only use when he's in front. I guess we can use another defend card. And that will put her in front. Okay, we used up all of our points. Yeah, I should have used her defend first, so she would be in the back. I mean, he has more HP. So he will defend. Well, I guess it's too late to defend. It's a great system. Both of your heroes have HP. I forgot what happens when one of your heroes is killed. But I don't want to find out. And as you can see, you get more and more items. And some of them will reveal the map in another location. So you kind of have to be careful. Otherwise, you might run out of supplies to free the map. And the ones that are accessible are shown like this. So I guess we can use this one. Fine tutorial, I understand. We can go over here. I guess you just have to maximize the use of your resources. If Soroku is leading, gain 2 block. I'm not sure they have items right now. Sword of Destiny, legendary. She gains 3 power. Okay, so... That's an interesting mechanic as well. The game just looks amazing. This is like a fairy tale come to life. Some of the things you can interact, some of the things are only for show, and some of them are really tough battles like that one.
Ready, big good luck. You will need it.
Pay gold to draft a card. Well, we have a lot of gold. So let me see... combo. It costs one and less energy. Whirlwind. Oh, we'll definitely get that one. Damage and block. I also think you can buy items from him.
Some use of this.
Like cards, gems... quills and some other stuff. Anyway, it's a great game. Let's leave the shop because I don't know too much about the full release because I didn't play it before recording the video. My experience is from the demo, and when you get such a great experience from a demo, you know the game will be great. Look at the little guys, they're so fluffy. She deals more damage when she's in front. Yeah. So attack with her and then defend with him. We'll attack him because he has more health. Well, I guess we can kill him now. and they want to use buffs. Okay, let's put him in front. I guess that was a mistake, because ultimately if they don't attack, there's no reason for you to put him in front. I could have attacked with her. Well, he doesn't have any blocks, but she doesn't have any blocks either, so let's use this card. That card is amazing. Exactly, it was very fun. Explosive pigment. Pile of gold. Okay, let's do this combat and then we'll have to unveil more terrain around us. I'm not sure which game I want to stream right now. I wanted to stream Red Solstice, but that one is a little buggy. Single player will be for YouTube, and multiplayer will be for streaming on YouTube. It's all enemies for 12. Okay, I guess these guys are a lot beefier. He's skipping the... Oh! That's a big mistake. Ah, I forgot again to attack with her. My mistake. I guess if you block, you go in front. They're still sleeping. Also, it shows over here, he'll go in front, it will switch. I guess that little circle around the cost of the card is a switch. I guess they'll attack right now for 18 damage. So let's only do this for the block. So let's block. Let's attack him. And then let's block again. I mean, he'll still take some damage, but it'll be okay. Okay, you need to remember a lot of things when you're playing the game. For better or for worse. That's 12 damage. No, I don't think we have to block 24 damage. Okay, these guys are very bad. You have to use all of your damage in the first rounds, otherwise they'll kite you down. Well, I don't want her to take a lot more damage, so I guess... Yeah, let's just attack like this and then we'll have him use a block. That's a lot of damage. This is getting ridiculous with that silly amount of damage. I hope we can heal him soon. Also, it looks like he has a metal armor on his armor. His arm is actually a metal arm. Weird. Also, she's put in front and then she attacks. Okay, that explains why that does more damage. So I guess the effect of moving her position happens before the attack. Okay, that will reveal more ground. I guess this will be the right location to use this. So what's the speed? It has two value, okay. Well, I guess it will be more important to not take damage during the fights. It has two spirit. That was interesting. I don't remember that in the demo. A statue to get a gem. I think you can apply gems to the cards. So let's see, Whirlwind.
Very well.
So this card has one action point, it has reduced cost, okay. Sorry, but when I'm playing a really great game, I can't really think about stuff. No, that's OP. That's so sad. Oh, that heals both heroes. Okay, I don't... Let's draft another card. Attack for 24 damage. Slam. So that means I can use 2 cards and it will cost 3. I can't really use the slam right now. What is courage? Gain 1 energy and lose a star. Oh. So that is 1 more energy for the next turn. Oh man, this is so annoying. Okay, so let's read this carefully. If this card, if the card played this turn belonged to the other hero, yeah, but which hero does this card belong to? Horse Master, swap your whatever. I guess you can put other gems in the cards to make them more useful, so let's read this more carefully. So I guess I need to play one hero for one card for that hero and one card for that hero, and then I need to play the high five. And then I can play another card. Well, this seems very... Okay, let's take it. It's very hard to use from what I can read. Okay. So, what do I want to have for free? Let's keep it. Maybe we'll have a better one next time. Also, I'm not getting a lot of attack cards, which is kind of worrying. Also, is the brush over here. And as you can see, the more things you unlock, the more... you have a lot more bonuses. Wow. Another draft. Spend an all of your energy, attack 10 times for the amount spent. Hammer time. I guess you can do 30 damage if you wanted. Attacks all enemies for 15. Oh, okay. That's the one I want. Okay, this guy has all of the good stuff. Looks like that last fight will be very hard to reach, but let's do this one first. Okay, so as you can see, it's 50% exploration, 50% managing your resources, your buffs and all of that cool stuff. 15 points of damage, that's silly damage. Okay, this is a lot of reading, but I guess we'll just get a bonus of 2 block. I think we should attack as fast as possible. Yeah, let's attack as fast as possible. This will get very bad soon. So, this one attacked. So we get 2 block at the beginning of the round and it also attacks. And it's also unable to be attacked. Okay, that's a great card then. That will put us in front. Whirlwind will also put us in front, so I guess we want to charge someone. I guess we can't attack him. I got super lucky because I got those gems and I also got those 2 cards that deal a lot of damage. So right now we won't take any damage. Which is great because we're kind of running low on health anyway. Okay, so let's see how this works. But we only have cards for Soroku, so I guess this card is useless. I mean, we'll get 1 more energy next turn, so it's basically a way to save your energy. Well, I guess it can be useful in certain situations, but it's a lot of thinking around the card. I have to delete it. I don't like it. Yeah, give me something to damage or something really good. Ally. Also, this is another spirit, but we actually have to play him in the game. Activate. Once per turn, ally uses one spirit. Okay, so it'll basically give me 4 action points, but I have to spend 3 action points. That means denying me one turn. Nope. Well, unless I can get another gem to slot in, slot over there. Dagger, stacks, attacks for 2 dissolves. Ally. So he'll basically give me a dagger each turn. Well, I guess he's good for the long run. 2 points of damage each turn forever is a good idea. I want to choose him, but it's very hard to use in the beginning. But he looks so friendly. Also, think about it. We don't have a lot of high energy cost cards, so might be a mistake to use that one. Okay, let's unlock this one, so we have a vision over here. Oh, a huge pile of gold. Well, I like gold. Yeah, I might stream this if Red Solstice doesn't solve the problems. I mean, they're both great games, but this one has something special. Oh, a lot of enemies. Well, good thing we have the Fire Breath. Come on, don't tell me this will kill everyone. Shortest combat in the history of card games. You just use a card and 4 enemies fall. What? Can't I use it right now? Oh, that's so silly. Okay, I guess you have to discard that one and take this one. And use this one right now. I should have thought of that. I should have thought of that before. Anyway, not such a big problem, because now we can advance. That's a lot of damage. 6, 11, 15 points of damage. I guess we just have to block everything as best we can. That is until we get the fire-breathing one. What are you guys, ghosts or a forest wisp? You're about to be a cooked forest wisp. I guess I should attack it first. Then the whirlwind. And then the defend, maybe. Okay, so... an attack. A whirlwind. Okay, so it's automatically used. Nice, that's nice. I don't have to use it, so it makes a lot more sense. So I just have to use one ability from her and one ability from him. I guess we have to block. This will be a little painful. Oh, actually it's not painful because I got a lot of blocks from that other card. Oh, nice. Discard a card and random, so I have to be careful of that one. Well, actually I don't have to do anything about it, because I can just charge her. And then use this one. Oh wow, that card carries the entire game, or at least the entire first round for me. No, I don't think I want another card, so I guess we cleared most of the map. Looks like there are no more encounters over here, probably just some small pieces of gold here and there. Okay, so you unlock more stuff for them as you collect the cards. No, super nice. I didn't know you selected that.
I've got this.
Cover my back.
Follow me.
Okay, so I can choose to start with him, but I wanted the other one. Oh, I wanted the quick reflexes. Oh man. Well, I guess this one is for the long run, but again, I just wanted that other one. Okay. Okay, so that's a permanent upgrade card, I think. I don't want to use that right now. Okay, let's see the other combat. This is great. We'll do the boss and then I'll end the video, but this is already super nice. Super good. I can't use the high five this turn. Fifteen points of damage. Well, that's not so bad. Wait, I actually got discarded that other time. I guess we'll not take any damage this turn. I'm actually stumbling into great synergies and I don't even know it. Fire breathing. Do I want to play a card? Okay, let's play the spirit card right now and then the defend. And probably then the strike where I can't target him. And then breathe the fire so I don't lose any cards. Okay. What, he got actually killed by the spirit? Yeah, he got killed by the spirit. That's funny. 18 points of damage. I guess that's the first dagger. Oh, but because she is using it, it does 5 damage. Oh, that's actually great. So the cards hero uses are actually benefiting from their bonuses. So he has 17 points. Do I have enough damage? No. Not even close. Defend and guard. I need to look at the cards better. Why is this just a straight up better version of the defend? I don't know. Okay, so that's 14. Yeah, let's just use an attack. I mean, a little bit of damage doesn't hurt that much. Oh, it actually increased my block. Okay, that guy is funny. The noble ink doesn't stack well, that's silly. I guess we should use the inks a lot more before we start the combat. Golden Fairy? What is this, like a hidden boss? Oh, this is so silly. Okay, so I just have to kill it very, very fast. Pinata. In 3 turns I have to kill it, otherwise... let's just do it like this. And then the fire breathing. And then that, and then this. I don't think I can do enough damage to kill it. But we'll definitely try our best. Yeah, it's very hard to kill. Yeah, this will be the last round while it's here, right? So let me see, attacks for 10, dagger. And what does it do next turn? It will flee, right? The enemy intends to run away, okay, so I need 12 points of damage. Wait, I guess I have 12. Okay, I have 12. Actually managed to kill it, that's impressive. That's a lot of coins we just got over there. Luckily, I mean, I'm not sure what else we can use the coins for, but it's better to have them than to not have them. Just draft another card. Or until the end of your turn. 16 block. Then attack the leading enemy for damage equal to your block. 8 block, so... But doesn't... Okay, so this doesn't put him in front from what I can see. No, okay, let's skip that one, because I don't think those are good ideas. Let's also try to find more secrets around the here. Well, nothing revealed, but I guess we did okay for this round. We got the golden fairy or whatever that was. So can we buy permanent buffs? Each turn you gain 3 block. Add a random card of the equipped hero to your hand. It costs 1 this battle. Well, I guess we just bought a lot of passive stuff. I mean, it's not really big or important, but it will add up over time. Yeah, I'm pretty upset that I got warmed up instead of the strong reflexes. Instead of the quick reflexes. Well, I guess it will be okay. Like I said, in the long run, it will be better. So let's see what crazy battle we have ahead of us. Queen's Assassin, okay. 1 point of damage and a major debuff. Spyglass. Okay, that, she is stealth, so that means I can't attack her, which is not cool. Do I want the 12 damage? I think I want the 12 damage. No, but then she'll be in front. Whatever. Let's let her be in front. I guess that was a critical hit. It did double damage. From where did I get that card? Oh, at the start of each battle. Okay, that was actually a card that gave a lot of utility to me. Do I want block or do I want more damage? I guess we want to go for more damage. Now let's see what major debuff we get. That's a lot of debuffs. I don't know what that did. Okay, I guess we just have to kill the defender first of all. Will be 10 damage and that would be okay, that should be enough. Well, I think I want to use whirlwind first, yes. And then this one. Okay, this was actually a lot easier than my other fight that I played in the demo. I mean, she loses a bit of HP, but not too much, nothing too crazy. Spyglass. Oh, I don't have any defend cards, but that shouldn't be a problem. Let's put her on defend, let's put that over there. The next two attacks, so that means this one. And this one. And this one. That was so funny. I guess you get that card every time. Embellish pages, rough diamond. You don't share a total block. Hmm. What card do I want to have more block? I guess you want a card... I'll just have to think about it.
Hey, what's over there?
Yeah, what's over there? Exactly. Did that open up other tiles or was that only a tease? Yeah, it was only this because I don't have any other potions to open up that last slot in order to get that gold. Okay, do I want anything else from the merchant or is this it? I guess I can buy another shadowed gem. Let's see, lacerate, attack and bleed. Nope. Gain block and retreat. Nope. I want this one, shoot them up. I don't think I have to defeat the enemies with this card in particular. Okay, let's just take that one and we'll have to apply the gems. I'll apply the gems off camera because that's a lot of thinking. So let's see what happens when you cross the portal. Oh, that was not the boss battle. This is the boss battle. Okay, then we'll apply the gems right now. I think the defend card should have more. Yeah, no, the guard card will actually have this one over here, the shadow gem.
I'm keeping this one.
And this one, well, I'll just have to think about it. I mean, I could put this card on the high five card and pretend it's okay. Come on, use it.
Nice one.
Okay, so that was not the boss. I thought it was a bit easy. So that was an elite fight and this is the real boss. Okay, he looks like a rat. He looks like a Skaven out for our blood. Platon, attack for 25 points of damage. Are you joking? This is so good. Okay, let's use that. I don't think I'll use the block. I forgot. Does the block remain? Does the block remain over the rounds? I guess the block doesn't transfer over the rounds. So 3 block plus 2 equals 5. 11 points of damage. Okay, so I just need one defend card, which I don't have. Yes. Okay, so that puts her in front. Why? Okay, I guess she'll get the stack of courage. So she gets the stack of courage. Okay, nice. I mean, if she's in front, that's even better because now she can use her attacks with the bonus damage. Okay, this boss fight is turning out to be a lot easier. And I should get another flatten card soon, right? Maybe. 22 damage. Okay, I guess we should guard first of all. Yeah, that would have been a bigger gamble. The enemy intends to use a buff. Well, that buff will be our last. So he attacked last, so if I use her now. Okay, so it doesn't carry over, so you have to use it the same round, okay. is enraged when he's under half health, so that he'll do 45 points of damage. Well, that's a big oof. And I don't have a lot of defensive cards. I also can't kill him, and I also can't swap my characters around. Well, that's bad. Well, I guess she'll almost die. Well, she's actually dead. I mean, she's out cold.
Steal yourself. This will not be the end.
The enemy intends to use a debuff. Okay, so I guess we just have to sing that song one more time. 41 points of damage. Okay, that will not be a problem. Since we can revive her right now. Come on, revive her. 18 points of damage. 12. I guess we can do it. What? Why? Oh, that was part of the story. Okay, that scared me for a while.
What kind of loot did we get?
Can't say it was very easy, but we managed to pull it. Pull through. 100 gold. Permanent upgrade. Choose a pile. Reduce its cost by 1, but what does it cost? Add headbangs? What? But it costs energy. Also impact. Phalanx. I guess I'm okay with Feria, whatever that is. Oh, we can add it. But what's the difference? Reduce this core cast by 1, reduce this cost by 1. It says reduce its cost by 1. Does it mean all of the cards in my hand will cost one less action or what? I'm not sure. Every ally gains 1 spirit. That would be super handy. I can dissolve the knife, so if I get that guy and dissolve the knife each turn, I'll get 1 energy every turn. That's to draw more cards. I'm not sure I can use those. Yeah, let's get the Mecha Turbine. It's the one that is really useful for me. Well, I guess I want to give it to Soroko. Chapter 2, Lost in the Oversky. That was actually pretty amazing. Like I said, this is one of those games that you just have to play more and more to see. Well, the game crashed. No matter, let's see each other in the next episode. Bye.